So going back to our many core challenges, we have seen that when the number of cores grows, so does the coherence traffic on the chip. And for that, we needed a scalable on-chip network such as a mesh and the directory coherence, which we have already seen in our cache coherence lesson. Another thing that having more cores will make more difficult is that as the number of cores goes up, the off-chip traffic that we need goes up. To have decent performance, we will, as we increase the number of cores, increase the number of on-chip caches. So if we have 4 cores, we have 4 level 1 and possibly level 2 caches. When we have 64 cores, we'll have 64 level 1 and level 2 caches. So each core doesn't really generate more misses, but it generates the same number of misses regardless of how many cores we have. So we have the same number of misses per core. So as we have more cores, the number of memory requests, which is what we do when we have a miss, would go up in proportion to the number of cores. Now know that the number of pins, the number of those little wires sticking out of a chip, does go up slowly, but not in proportion or anywhere close to in proportion to the number of cores. So if we double the number of cores, possibly we get maybe 10% more pins, but that's it. Because these pins have to physically be large enough to not break when we are moving the chip around and plugging it into a motherboard. So what happens is we get some little improvement in off-chip throughput, while our demand for it basically grows in proportion to the number of cores. So our off-chip available throughput becomes a bottleneck. So we need to reduce the number of memory requests that we generate per core. And the way we do that is to make the last level cache, which in most today's processors is the level 3 cache, shared so that all cores go to that cache and its size is shared equally by all the cores. And the size of that cache needs to go up in proportion to the number of cores as it goes up. So as we double the number of cores, we should at least double the size of the last level cache. But there is a problem to having one huge LLC like this. Such a large cache would be slow, and if it's really one single cache, it would have one entry point where we enter the address and expect the data out. And that entry point needs to be somewhere on our chip that now possibly has a mesh or another advanced network. And that means that that one point will be where we send all of the level 2 misses. So it would become a bottleneck. Pretty much now we don't get to use all of the links equally. This set of links that go to this entry point for the cache would get much more traffic than the other links. If we double the number of cores, then those links around the entry point get double the traffic. So what we do is we don't have just one big last level cache, we have what is called a distributed last level cache. Now let's see what that looks like.